Hello students, welcome back to another video of calculus. Today we will discuss composition of continuous functions and some more definitions. So first of all, the composition of continuous function, that is the composition of two continuous functions is composite. So let f from a to r be continuous function at some x is equals to c, at a point c, if g from set b to r is also continuous, at some point b is equals to f of c, at the image of c, that is at the image of c under f, this function g is continuous at point f of c, then the composition g composite f is continuous at c, g composite f is continuous at c, that is function f suppose from a to r and b is subset of r and function g from that set b to again r, these two both the functions are continuous, then their composition is from composition g composite f. That is first of all we will apply function g, sorry function f from a to r, that is if our f of a is subset of b, then we get, for that we have the write one more statement, in order to assure that g composite f is defined on all of a, that is the domain of f, also we need to assume that f of a is subset of b, that is image of this f, image of this a under f is the subset of b, that is suppose this is the range set and this range set f of a is subset of this whole set b and the function g is from this b to r, then their composition exists and their composition is continuous. Now we will take one theorem, only statement of the next theorem. Let a comma b are the subsets of r and f from a to r, be continuous on a, and g from b to r be continuous on b, if f of a is subset of b, then the composition g composite f from a to r, is continuous on a, function f from a to r is continuous and g from b to r is continuous, then their composition g composite f from a to r is continuous. This is the statement, that is this definition is summarized in this statement. So, this is the important one as far as multiple choice questions concerned. Now, the continuous function on interval, we have seen the function is continuous on single point. Now, we will see the next topic, continuous functions on intervals. Continuous function on intervals. So, first of all, one definition, definition. A function f from a to r is said to be bounded. A function f from a to r is said to be bounded. Is said to be bounded if there exists a constant suppose m greater than 0 such that mod of f of x is less than or equals to m for all x belongs to A, that is for every element of domain image of that element must be less than or equals to m, then that function is said to be bounded function. Now the next is boundedness theorem. Boundedness theorem. So let I is equals to close interval AB. Is close and bounded interval. B a closed and bounded interval. And let f from I to R be continuous on I, that is f from this interval to real line is continuous function, is continuous on I, means this function is continuous at every element of this I, then this function f is bounded, then f is bounded function, f is bounded on I. So the function, if we define a continuous function on close and bounded interval, then this function is also bounded on given domain. Now the next definition is definition of absolute maximum. Let A is subset of R and f from this set A to R is function, then we say that f has an absolute maximum. On given interval A, this function f has an absolute maximum on given interval A if there exists a point suppose x1 belongs to A such that f of x1, that is image of this x1 under f, is greater than or equals to f of x, that is for all x belongs to A, that is image of this x1 is the greatest among all the images of given domain, so we say that a given function has absolute maximum if there exists some element in domain A whose image is greater than or equals to image of the rest of the elements in that domain, then we say that given function has an absolute maximum in given domain. Now similar definition for absolute minimum. We say that f has an absolute minimum. F has an absolute minimum on given interval A if there exists a point suppose x2 belongs to A such that f of x2 is less than or equals to f of x for all x belongs to A. That is, there exists some element in domain A such that whose image, that is f of x2, is less than or equals to the image of rest of the elements in that domain, that is f of x2 is less equal f of x for all x belongs to A. This is the definition of absolute minimum. So, here this x1 is said to be absolute maximum and this x2 is said to be absolute minimum. So, we say that given x1 is an absolute maximum, is an absolute maximum for f on A, for given function f on the interval A, and x2 is an absolute minimum for given function f on the domain A, if they exist. Now, the next theorem is maximum minimum theorem. Maximum minimum theorem. That is, if the maximum and minimum exist. So, let interval I is equals to closed interval A B be closed and bounded interval, closed and bounded interval, closed and bounded interval, and let f from domain I to R be continuous function on I, be continuous on I, then that function f has an absolute maximum and absolute minimum, absolute maximum and absolute minimum on interval I. If the continuous function is defined on closed and bounded interval, then that function has absolute maximum and minimum on the given interval. This is the statement of maximum minimum theorem. And the next theorem is location of root theorem. Location of roots theorem. So, let interval I is equals to closed interval A B be a closed and bounded interval, closed and bounded interval, and let f from the interval I to R be continuous on I, be continuous on I, if f of a is less than 0 is less than f of b, image of f is less than 0 is less than image of b, or if f of a is greater than 0 is greater than f of b, that is, if the image of a is greater than 0 is greater than image of f of b, then there exists a number c belongs to interval a b, open interval a b, such that f of c is equals to 0. That is, if function I is sorry function f is defined from I to R is continuous function, and image of f that sorry image of A is less than 0 is less than image of B, or image of A is greater than 0 is less than image of B, then there exists one root of that function, that is one element in that domain open interval AB for which f of C is equals to 0, that is C is the root of given function. So this is the statement of location of root theorem. Now in the next lecture we will see the generalization of this location of root theorem or Bolzano's theorem. So this is the location of root theorem. Function f from I to R is continuous on given interval, given closed and bounded interval I, and if f of A is less than 0 less than f of B, or f of A is greater than 0 is greater than f of B, then there exists one element in the open interval AB for which f of C is equals to f of that element is equals to 0.